tomorrow. So just start with the feet on the ground and just gently rotate through the body. Allow the arms to hit the body. Really let them flop. Allow the feet to lift up off the ground as you rotate. And then start to bring the heels down onto the ground and just allow yourself to rotate through the torso. Mulabandha, draw up through your pelvic floor, draw your belly towards your spine. Start to create some space between the ribs and the hips. And just allow that momentum to just start to slow down to stillness. And rotating the thumbs outward, take a nice inhale, open up through the chest. Exhale, rotate the thumbs inwards. Tuck the tailbone under. Start peeling off the layers here. So big inhale, rotate the thumbs back. Lift through the chest, stay soft through the knees. Exhale. Rotate the thumbs inwards, tuck the tailbone under, soften through the back of the neck, allow the weight of the head to stretch the spine. When you're ready, inhale, stack the spine upwards. Lift the chest towards the ceilings, draw the shoulders down, spiral the thumbs outwards. And as you exhale, tuck the tailbone under, rotate the thumbs inwards, create the tension in the spine, gently tuck the tailbone under, and start to bring it a little bit further down towards the ground. Exhale. Inhale, roll up through the spine. Gaze towards the ceiling, open up through the chest. And as you exhale, rotate thumbs inwards, tuck the tailbone under, and work your way down a little bit further. Allow the crown of the head to hang. Let the weight of the head stretch the spine up. Gently move the tailbone from side to side. Direct the breath into the back of the ribs. Allow the legs to bend and straighten, just finding that hamstring stretch. So for you, if it means resting your chest on your thighs and just allowing the crown of the head to hang, or if you're able to keep your chest connected to your thighs, transfer your weight from leg to leg, gently trying to straighten out those legs. Turn and point your left foot. Walk your fingers beyond your left foot. Transfer your weight in and out. Look for the tension. Is it down through the side of the ribs? Is it in the lower back? Down through the hamstrings? When you're ready, rotate your foot in front and rotate your other one out, walking your fingers beyond your foot. Bend your opposite leg. Reach with the arms. Don't commit to the stretch. Keep moving through it. Just wiggle. Find those feet in line with the hip joints and bring yourself down into a squat if it's available to you. If it's not available, transfer the weight from the fingers to the heels. Even if it means falling off the back of the heels, it's totally okay. Bring those feet back up again. Nestle the elbows inside the knees. See if you can lengthen through the spine. Take a big inhale. Exhale, lengthen through the spine. Allow the pelvic floor to open. Inhale, reach behind you, keep the shoulders down. Inhale, exhale, reach behind you, soft through the shoulder. Inhale, exhale. So really blocking that opposite elbow into the opposite knee as you reach away. On your next rotation, stay here for a little while. Notice as you breathe out, you can get just that little bit more rotation. If it's going up into the neck, place the hand on the coccyx or the tailbone. Keep the spine long. And on your next exhale, rotate round. Block the elbow into the knee. Exhale as you rotate. If it's going up into the shoulder, bend at the elbow. Pop the palm of the hand on the sacrum. Just rolling onto those toes, just stretching out through the toes. You're going to drop onto the knees. So onto the knees, reach back, lift through the hips, inhale. Exhale, drop back onto the feet, back into the knees, up through the hips.
exhale. So
see if you can synchronize your breathing. You don't have to go at the same speed as what I am doing, but slowly, slowly, you'll start to get just a little bit more of a back bend. You'll feel that strong anterior chain opening. Maybe start to explore what's available just as you're waking up that body. Rocking and transferring that weight through the toes. Place those hands on the ground. Send the tailbone up towards the ceiling. Really let the crown of the head hang. Inhale as you look up, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, pull the crown of the head down. Feel the weight slightly forward on the toes or the fronts of the feet. Notice how it changes the stretch in the back of the calves. Inhale, look up, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, pull the crown of the head down. Wiggle, wiggle, one more time. Inhale, look up, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, pull the crown of the head down. Inhale, look up, anchor into the hands. Step the right knee back for me. Knee, 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 knee. Tuck your tailbone under for me. Same hand, same knee. Reach up with the right hand. Keep the tuck on through the tailbone and just tip over that midline for me. Start to flirt with the hips coming further forward, but really focusing on tucking that tailbone under. If the ground is close for you, I have short arms. Otherwise, just bring that weight forward. Breaths here as you reach and sweep that hand down to the ground. Draw the opposite knee towards the armpit and just reach away. So just a couple of breaths here, just introducing yourself to a twist. And then bring both hands down inside the knee. Allow the knee to draw out to the side and shift your weight from left to right. Look for your tightline. So when you found your tightline, you can lift the chest, relax the hips down. Gently, gently start to contract the front foot back towards the back knee. Just start very gently and then really give it a bit of an effort. One big breath, and then as you breathe out, just let those legs relax. Maybe walk the toes a little bit further forward. Again, shift the weight left to right. Look for the tight line. One more time. Inhale, look up. As you exhale, gently contract your front foot back towards your back knee. Draw your back knee towards your front foot. That's the knee. 3, 2, 1, and relax if it's available. We want to come down on that inside elbow first. That might be too strong. It's not a competition. We're not trying to get somewhere. We're just trying to create a bit more space. Come back in the nerve glide, so both hands are the side of the foot. You're going to pull this toe up towards the ceiling. You're going to round out through the back, pull the shoulders up towards the ceiling and gently drop the chin towards the chest, the forehead towards the knee, and then release, inhale. So if you have a bit of neural tension there, always, maybe just release it and just give that foot a bit of a windscreen wiper, just flip that femoral head in this hip socket, that can loosen it up a little bit. Transfer the weight forward. Inhale, exhale. Create some space between the stomach and the thigh. Chin to the chest, forehead towards the knee. Beautiful. So just getting some balance, place the hands on the knee. See if you can concave the spine back the other way. So we're trying to square the hips up. Squeeze the glute on the back leg. Stabilize those hip joints. It may just be that you're just going to open up through the chest. Inhale here. Exhale. We're going to point the foot this time. I'm going to use my hands for balance. I'm trying to stick this tailbone out. Beautiful. So just 3 times. Inhale. Exhale. Point that front foot. Pull back through that left ball socket. Bow through the crown of the head. Inhale. You don't have to reach up if you don't want to. You could just look like this. Exhale. Hands. balance and support. Beautiful. And then coming up onto the toes on the back foot, step that other foot back and find your push-up position. Mass of the hands over the back of the mass of the shoulders. Hollow stomach, so drawing up through the belly, squeezing through the glutes. Inhale here. Exhale, gently draw the hips down towards the ground. Stay lifted in the shoulder girdle. Stay long through the spine. Smile across the clavicle. And just gaze towards the ceiling. On your next breath out, draw back into downward dog. Come up onto your tippy toes and make a wave through your spine. So big arch through the shoulders. Shift the weight over the hands as the hips transfer down towards the ground. Open up through the front of the chest. Squeeze through the glutes. And just here, just gaze over the right shoulder. And gazing over the left shoulder. And gazing back up towards the horizon of the room. And draw it back into downward dog. One more time, just a wave through the body, up onto the toes of the back feet, arch through the back, shift the weight over the hands as the hips roll forwards, opening up through the chest. And then exhale, downward dog. So if you need to have a little walk on the spot, if the calves are tight, feel free just to explore your dog. If it means coming up onto the toes, drawing through the heels, bend the legs. Even drawing those knees towards the ground. And then just a gaze through the hands. We're gonna step the right foot in between the hand, come down onto that left knee. So we're just gonna do the other side. So tuck the tailbone under. Give it a wiggle if you need to. Same hand, same knee. Inhale as you reach up. Pull that left shoulder down and just tip over the midline. Start to flirt with drawing those hips a bit further forward. Feel like the ground is a little bit closer. It never is. I'm just going to come off my legs, take my weight all the way across my body. Take a couple of breaths here. And on the next breath out, sweep that hand forward, place it on the ground. Draw the opposite knee in towards the opposite armpit, reach away. Just a couple of breaths here. And then bring both hands down inside the foot. Making sure this foot is beyond the knee. Allow the hips to relax and just give yourself a little shift left, right. You're looking for the tight line. So once you've found that line that is the tightest for today, take a little inhale, lift the chest. And on your next exhale, contract, relax. We're going to try and move this front foot towards the back leg, gently to start with. Give it a really good effort. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Inhale, lift the chest. Let the hips relax. One more time. Inhale, contract. Pull the front foot back towards the back knee. 3, 2, 1, and relax the hips. Walk that foot a little bit further forward. Bring both hands either side of the foot. Let's go into that nerve line. So you're going to pull back onto that front heel, pull these toes up towards the ceiling, suck in through the stomach, arch the back, drop the chin towards the chest and the forehead towards the knee until you feel that neural tension or a stretch in the hamstring. Stay there for one breath and then glide off it. One more time. Pull those toes up, arch through the back. Now if there's any neural tension there, you can always give that foot a little bit of a wiggle. Just jiggle that femoral head across the sciatic there, in through the glute. And try one more time. So we're going to transfer the hips forward. So if you really need to adjust that front foot to climb that leg, so you're feeling nice and balanced. So we're going to inhale, concave this spine back the other way. Exhale, point the front foot. Try and pull back through this ball socket.
So trying to create length through the back of the front hamstring.
Inhale. If you want, you can reach up. Exhale. If your balance is awesome, you can point forwards. Mine's not very good. Onto the toes on the back foot and step back into that push-up position. So bending at the knees, drawing yourself back into beast, and then drawing the back of the legs of one into downward dog. Just walk those toes a little bit together. Come up onto tippy toes. We're going to shift the weight over hands in a wave. Bring that right knee towards the right armpit, and then we're going to send that right leg straight up to the ceiling. We're going to let it flop over the body in a three-legged dog. We're going to rotate onto the outside lip and land. Keep that left leg straight, right leg bent. Nice. Come back up onto the toes, reach that foot higher to the ceiling, knee towards the forehead, and then plant that knee on the ground into half pigeon. Give those hips a bit of a wiggle. Walk the fingers back. See if you can sink the sit bone down towards the ground. Loosens, walk the back leg across. Hold hands down. You can use your thumbs in your eyes. Just in the sockets of your eyes, gently find the ridges. Take a big breath in. Really just working your thumbs along the ridges of your eye sockets. And using your fingertips just to gently do the bottom ring. Just transfer your weight over onto the sit bone of this right leg. Gaze over your left shoulder and your back leg. See if you can walk your hands around to the arch of your foot. Push your foot into your hand just to create this really nice stretch across the chest. And then walk the fingers around to the outside lip of the foot. Use your right hand for support. Roll onto the front into full pigeon. So have a little play with what it feels like or what's available. It's not necessarily about jamming that heel to the bottom. About trying to tuck and square the tailbone. Just a couple of nice full breaths there. And just releasing through that leg. Onto the toes on the back foot, stepping back, chaturanga. So finding that strong push-up position, squeeze the glutes, hollow stomach. Shift the weight over the hands. Bring the hands down and see if you can just hover close to the floor. Draw the pubic bone towards the floor, draw up through the stomach, and then pull yourself forward into chaturanga. So really opening up through the front of the chest. Curl over through the toes, downward dog. Get the sensation of lifting the tailbone, lifting the back of the hamstrings. If the legs are straight, make sure the quads are engaged. If they're a little bit bent, that's totally okay as well. Think of wrapping the shoulder blades around the ribcage, squeezing the imaginary basketball between the elbows. Staying really soft through the head. My hands are not gripping enough. Bring the toes close together. Come up onto the tippy toes so you're bending through those toe joints. Shift the weight forward over the hands. Bring that left knee towards the side of the elbow. Shift the weight back up so the leg comes up towards the ceiling in a three-legged dog and allow that leg to flop over the body. We're going to rotate. Keep the right leg straight, left leg bent, squeeze through the glutes. We're going to pop back over onto that foot. Reach that leg nice and high. Knee to forehead as we shift the weight and plant the left knee on the ground in between the hands. A little wiggle. Shift the weight left to right. And gently walk that back leg across.
So you can walk your fingers back, sinking that left, sit bone down towards the ground. Breathing nice and relaxed. Again, walking the way forward through the hands. If you want to do your eye sockets again, it's always, it's a nice pressure. It's just enough weight with the elbows on the ground. It's not too much. And don't forget fingertips for the bottom of the socket. Sit bone, gaze over the right shoulder, have a look down at that right foot. See if you can bend the back leg, grab hold of the back foot, and walk the hand around to the arch of the foot. So just allow the chest to stretch to start with, really push that foot into the hand. Just focus on opening up through the front of the chest. And walking the fingers around to the other side of the outside limb of the foot, and using the other hand to keep that support. Slide the back knee behind you. Play with how close you can get that heel to your bottom. Do you feel as that heel is being drawn towards the bottom that you're lifting yourself out of the stretch? If that's the case, maybe focus more on pushing the back knee down towards the ground, tucking the tailbone under. Just allow yourself a couple of nice solid breaths here. Slight pause on the in-breath at the top. A slight pause on the out breath at the bottom. Just allowing those hips to relax a little bit deeper. And just release. Come up onto the toes on the back foot. Step back into downward dog. We're going to wave that space over. So just waving through the upper shoulders, weight over the hands, draw the hips down towards the ground. Squeeze through the glutes. So you're rotating your femur bones outwards. So you're lengthening through the tailbone. Big inhale, draw back downward dog. Walk those feet towards your hands for me. I want you to imagine that you're putting enough weight into the hands that you're drawing up through the belly to make yourself really light on your toes. It's the first part of the movement before we're piking up into handstand. So it's very strong on the stomach. So we can practice this with our feet on blocks, so our hands are below our feet. But we haven't done any hand drills this morning. Playing around with a little bit of make-believe at the moment. So up onto the hands, take a lot of the weight into the hands, so really locking out the arms like you're doing a handstand, and then just walking those feet as far forward so you can almost take the weight right onto the tops of the feet. So just hold it there. And just releasing. Give those hands a little bit of a shake out. Waving like the queen on speed is a good one. So that sort of starts to go into the pads of the thumbs. That's a really nice one. And just the shaking, waking up. So that's around about 30 minutes. That's just a really quick flow to get your body moving. It's a precursor to a whole lot of other stuff. Let me know what you think. Is the sound okay? Is the light okay? Can you hear me when I'm upside down? Things like that. Just wave through the hands and little wiggles.